sit right here.
Sal's out and about with his daughter. Uh-huh. This is actually Sal's niece, Mia, who's helping us out today.
Love the dog, man. Love it.
Thank you, yeah. Mia, say to the man, you don't go to a job interview dressed like that, do you?
You don't go to a job interview dressed like that, do you?
Baby. It's okay. Talk to daddy. I'm sorry.
It's work hours and he's wearing shorts.
Back her up, Sal.
I mean, odds are you're not gonna get a job dressed like that. If you went into an interview, you're right. And I know she's a straight shooter. You know, she's astute.
Mia, say to the guy, my daddy's unemployed.
My daddy's unemployed.
Again.
All right, babe.
Seems like forever.
Seems like forever.
All right, but you can't just. Oh, God.
My daddy can't afford to vaccinate me.
All right, guys, now get in there. You have to agree with her. You haven't agreed yet.
I know, because we don't have the money right now.
Why couldn't you marry rich like this guy?
We don't know anything about him.
I know enough. Say to the man, I bet your wife is the breadwinner.
Back her up, Sal.
Shh.
She said that she thought your wife was the breadwinner?
Is that what you said?
Because I agree with my daughter about that perception that your wife is probably the breadwinner. Because I tell you what, takes one to know one, my man. I'm in the park in shorts, too.
Sal, nice save.
Hey, all right.
There we go.
All right, Mia, turn to the girl to your left and loudly say, I'm an accident.
I'm an accident.
Back her up.
Look at his face.
An accident.
Like a mistake. Yeah, I know. We talked about it. That was between us, though. You don't have to tell people.
Mia, say to the woman, Miss, I live in shame.
Miss, I live in shame.
You shouldn't be ashamed. I mean, it wasn't your fault, but now you're here and you're great, right?
Plus, he wanted a boy.
Right?
Plus, he wanted a boy.
Oh! Yeah.
I did.
Full disclosure, I did want a boy first because I wanted an older brother. Like, I had an older brother, yeah. And I feel like the protective thing, especially how sweet she is.
He wanted a boy or a Cocker Spaniel?
He wanted a boy or a Cocker Spaniel. I'm neither.
Okay.
I don't like it when you tell me to bark.
Oh, yeah, I know. Well, this has been significantly awkward. I think we should go see your mom at work now.
All right, Serena?
Yeah.
Let's do this.
She was out there with his daughter.
Yes, who is actually my niece. Serena and Mia will be helping us today.
Serena, you're gonna tap this guy on the shoulder and just say, my dad says hip hop was invented by white people.
Excuse me?
Oh, she just goes right for it.
My dad said that hip hop was invented by white people.
And what white group was that?
Back her up, that's your daughter.
Oh, I'm not her father. No, I'm not her father. You know what, that's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard in my entire life. I'm gonna correct that, yeah.
But dad.
Shut up, shut up and walk.
Wanna see? It's in the shade, not bad. So Sari, you're gonna turn to him and say this. You look like one of the firefighters on the calendar in Daddy's garage.
You look one of like the firefighters in Daddy's garage on the calendar.
Wait, what? What'd you say? Huh?
He looks like one of the firefighters on the calendar in your garage.
You do look like March.
You look like March.
I'm sure he's a very handsome man.
It's August, but Daddy keeps March up.
It's August, but Daddy keeps March up.
Now I get why you wanted to sit here.
Oh, now I get why you wanted to sit here.
Ferry's leaving. Let's go to Staten Island. Come on.
That was it? That was too much?
You keep your mouth shut about March. Mr. March is for me and me only.